Hey y'all, welcome back. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing a little bit of shopping and I'm going to take you guys along with me. I'm going to be going into TJ Maxx and Home Goods is like a block up the street, and then I'm going to head over to Target because Studio McGee released a couple of new things and then they re-released a couple of new things, and I don't know if they're in store or not yet, but I'm going to look. And then also Hearth and Hand by Magnolia released a bunch of new things yesterday as well. I'm going in Home Goods to look for an accent console table to go in my living room. Y'all, it's turning out that the Home Goods in my hometown is kind of sad. Kind of sucks sometimes, but I've asked one of the workers in there before how often they get trucks, and my Home Goods only gets a truck with new items like twice a week, sometimes once a week, versus some of the Home Goods in bigger stores that I've been to. Some of them get a truck once a day, and that's why they're able to stay so fully stocked because they have so much inventory. I wish we were that lucky with my local store, but we are not. So anyway, I have about 2 hours to shop. I just dropped my husband off right here at this restaurant. He is here for a union meeting for his job, and I'll pick him up in about 2 hours, like I said. So I'm going to go in Home Goods, TJ Maxx, and Target, and by that time it should be time for me to pick him back up. But at the beginning of this video, I'm going to show you a couple of new pieces that I already have at home. Part of it is me taking my IKEA bar cart back to IKEA, which is like 2 hours away, because I bought the wrong one the first time I went, and I exchanged the wrong one and got the right one, and then I put it together. And then a console that I got from Studio McGee came in last week, and I put that together, and it's already in the living room. I just haven't decorated it yet. So at some point in this video, I'll insert clips of those new items, but for now, let's go do a little bit of shopping. This is proof that nothing in my Home Goods ever gets changed out, exchanged out, or sold, because this particular accent console has been here forever, and so is this one. And now this one is on clearance for $2.89. Because all of us that shop in here have seen these things, these same things over and over, we want to see some new stuff. So I didn't show anything in TJ Maxx because it was not a good day for TJ Maxx. So what I did show you in Home Goods, that boucle bench that was in there, I've seen it so many times on so many different YouTubers shop with me's at Home Goods, and it's beautiful, but it's just not practical for the type of living that my husband and I live. And he works with horses. There's a lot of red dirt. I would never want him to sit on it. As a matter of fact, I wouldn't want anyone to sit on it. I wouldn't want anyone to touch it because they're just perfectly beautiful. And that second one that I showed you, the boucle one that was tipped over on the side, it was already dirty. And it's just from all of us that shop in these stores. We walk in there and we want to put our hands on. I'm very tactile when I shop and I want to touch and feel things. I'm very particular about things that I buy when it comes to like furniture pieces. So I wouldn't have bought them anyway, but they are beautiful to look at. I'm glad that I seen it in person, but my Home Goods is slacking and lacking this week as well. I still have an hour before I have to pick my husband back up. So what I'm going to do is I just order me some Chick-fil-A, and I'm sitting in the curbside order spot waiting on them to bring it out. I'm gonna sit here in the truck and have lunch, and then I may swing by Target. I really need to go back when I'm on my way to pick him up and buy that leopard print blanket that I showed y'all, because I'm gonna regret it if I don't go back and get it. So I think when I get done eating, I'm just gonna go back and get that blanket. Even though I don't need it, but I really, really want it. The best part about Chick-fil-A is definitely the lemonade. Y'all can fight me on this if y'all want to, but the only reason I come here is for the lemonade. Y'all, small but mighty, it's the perfect size bar cart, and I put it in the perfect spot, and I opened the back door to make sure that there was enough room, because I don't need anything blocking the doorway. But yeah, I love this cart. Like I said, it came from IKEA. I will link it down below if you guys might be interested. I think I may style it in the next video, unless I go around the house and like shop my home and find things to go on it. And I know I have some stuff. I know I have some mixed drink books that I can use for decor. And I already know that I bought some new like bourbon whiskey glasses to put on this like in January, and I've just been holding on to them. And I have some bar cart accessories. I don't want to open them because I'm not sure if I'm gonna keep them. I got them from Target, but I said on Amazon that I probably might like a little bit better. So yeah, like I said, I'm gonna get some of those bottles from outside, some of my prettier bottles, and bring them in. And either I'll style it in this video or I'll style it in the next video. But either way, I'll show you guys what I use to make this bar cart be pretty. And I could swing it around the corner if I want to. I could roll it outside. This is like the perfect little bar cart for me. And all the ones that I've been looking at on Amazon, I know they were massive and they look like the really shiny yellowy gold. So I'm glad that I got this one. And with it being so small, it'll help keep me from over decorating it, because I definitely will put way too much stuff on this thing. So I'm happy about this purchase, y'all. I hate that I had to go to IKEA twice to make sure I got the right one, but at least I finally got the right one. So what I'll do now is pull this cart around so I can show you everything that I styled it with. Y'all, why slide it over in this empty corner next to the TV? And I really like it over here too, but I'm not gonna leave it here. I'm just being ridiculous now. All right, I just slid it over here where there's better lighting so that you could see a little bit better. So let's start with the top shelf. All right, so this little plant situation right here, I made it. I got the vessel from the Dollar Tree. It was glass, and I just spray painted it white. The bar cart accessories behind it, I got from Target. This bottle right here in the front, I actually made it. I bought the bottle off of Amazon.
and I put our last name on it myself. I just haven't filled it with anything. And then I have a bottle of 1942, a bottle of Classe Azul, and a bottle of Hendrick's Gin. And then remember me saying earlier, I think I said it in this video, about the bourbon glasses that I've had since like January. They came in a set of six and I just put four of them back here. And then these coasters are coasters that I actually made with my small business. I just thought they were cool and they kind of went with the aesthetic that I'm going for. All right, so that's the top shelf. On the bottom, I have a bottle of Hennessy Black, a bottle of Grand Patron that is almost out because I love it so much. And then in the front here, I have two of my favorite wine bottle corks. And then up under those, I have a set of drink cutting boards that somebody bought me as a gift. I don't remember if it was a housewarming gift or a Christmas gift, but they were gifted to me. And then I have this teeny tiny little fiddle leaf plant that I got from Target a while back, and then some drink books up under it. But I think what I'm gonna do is take these drink books away because I think the drink books are what's throwing me off. It's just too busy, too much going on. And I think something a little bit more plain and simple might go a little bit better up under there. Maybe take the top book off because that bottom book is just plain gray. But the bottom book has also gotten wet before. See how the pages right there have been kind of messed up. So the books are just throwing me off. So the books may go away and I put something else on the bottom up under this little fiddle leaf plant. These glasses, oh my goodness, I've been waiting for I don't know how long to be able to use these glasses in this type of situation. My mom bought me these champagne glasses years ago. They've been in the cabinet all this time. They're trimmed in 24 karat gold. I've only used one of them like twice in the years that I've had them. So now I can display them and they go perfect on this bar cart. I just think they're gorgeous. So that is the way I styled the bar cart in a nutshell. Do you guys think I put too much on it? Is it just perfect? What do I need to take away? What do I need to add? I mean, besides the book situation, the books are throwing me off, so they gotta go. But what do you think? All right, y'all, remember when I said I was gonna bring my fiddle leaf tree in from the patio and bring it in the house, that tree right there? Well, I ended up bringing it in and I really like how it looks on this back wall back here. So I think that's where it's gonna live. And I also like my bar cart being under this window. I didn't think I was gonna like that, but it's really cute over there. And I think what made me like the tree being back here is that it gives this wall a bit of symmetry with my husband's curio liquor cabinet thingy back there. It gives this wall a little bit of symmetry. And I think it's gonna look really nice whenever I finally get to doing the family portrait gallery wall thing back there. I think that's gonna look really nice. And the bar cart actually looks really nice over here as well. And originally I thought it was gonna bother me when I hang the curtains back over here, but when I hang them back, they're not gonna be covering the blinds anyway. The curtains are just gonna sit, hang straight, and sit outside each side of the window anyway. So that's what we're gonna live with because I like it. And so this space right here, I haven't decided what I wanted to do over here yet. This pot won't stay here, y'all, but I'll tell you about that in a second. I looked at a media console on the Pottery Barn website, and it's like 105 inches long. I think it's called the Livingston. And I was really thinking about buying that and then just putting a faux tree right here instead of buying an accent console and putting it here. And I was going to move the clock and put the clock somewhere else and put a mirror there and have this whole styling decor moment there. But I really like the idea of just buying one super long console and putting it here and then just have a faux tree or something right there. But the thing about that, when the fall and winter months get here and it starts to get cold outside again, my husband is going to want his firewood holder thing to go back right there, and I don't want that really long media console to be in the way. So I may not end up buying that one. I may get one that's just a tiny bit smaller instead of 105 inches. Maybe something that's like 70 or 80 inches because I kind of like the idea of having something really long right there and not cluttering this wall up with a bunch of pieces. We'll see. I don't know. I may end up buying another accent console to go right there. It just depends. But I'm really picky when it comes to that stuff nowadays because I haven't bought furniture in 16, 18 years. So I'm being really picky about what I choose to put in here. And I think I'm okay with this being empty until I find exactly what I want. So this planter right here, I just happened to go in Home Goods yesterday and it was there and it was on clearance. And I've been looking at this thing for a long time. The original price of it was like 70 bucks. And I think I bought it for like $25 or something like that, y'all. Hang on a second, let me find the price tag because I just tore it off. Okay, so here's the tag for it. It was originally $70 and I got it for $29, but I feel like I got it for even cheaper than that because I bought another item that when I got it to the register, it was kind of broken. So they ended up giving me that other item for almost free. So I feel like that kind of reflected on the price of this as well. So anyway, I got it really cheap, y'all. And in the store, it was really, really huge. And then I get it in the house and it's like my living room just swallowed it up. But the plan is to put that tree that I DIY'd in a previous video, the plan is to put that faux plant in this pot. I probably won't do it until the next video, but that's the plan. It's really heavy because it's made out of concrete, but it's really heavy, really substantial, and I love it. And I think it goes in my space really well. And this is the console that I got from Target. I think the name of it is the East Bluff. It came from the Studio McGee and Threshold line. I think it's 60 inches long, but y'all, I love this thing. It has drawers on it, and the drawers have these antique brass looking handles. I don't know what I'm gonna put in the drawers, but I really like the look of this thing, y'all. It was really easy to put together. I caught it on sale. It ended up being like $247, I believe. And the original price of it is like $330. I don't know how the Lord blessed me with getting this thing on sale, but when I saw that price, I clicked and bought it right then because I felt like if I let it go another day or two and think about it, I was gonna miss it. And that's exactly what happened. The price went back up like 3 or 4 days later. I'm gonna link it below, but it's not on sale anymore. So I apologize for that. The original price is like $330 and it goes in and out of stock a lot. So if you catch it and you really like this, then I suggest getting it. The way that I plan on styling this is like putting two baskets down there for extra storage or putting like three smaller baskets down there for storage because my house doesn't have a lot of storage in it. So I have to be really creative when I come up with things. And so I figured putting some really nice baskets down there would not only be pretty, but they would serve as some functional storage. Also, this table right here, y'all, it was in the living room before we started this makeover in here. When I went through all of my home decor, I found it in there. So I decided to just stick it in the living room. It probably won't stay. I'll probably end up giving it to somebody, my daughter or somebody, I don't know. But the plan is if I'm gonna have a table on the end of the sofa here, I would really like it to be a wood accent table. But I like the size of this one. So for now, I just put it here just to see if that's something that we would like in here. So in the next video, I do plan on finally decorating my coffee table because all it ever has on it is remotes and drinks. I've never put anything on it. It's just been sitting like this. And I also plan on finally styling that console on the back wall. I'm gonna get it done, y'all. I'm tired of sitting here staring at blank stuff. I really didn't want to decorate anything until I got all of the bigger pieces in here, but I've just decided that I'm gonna go ahead and do it because that TV console wall, I can't decide on what I want to put there. But here's another look at the bar cart. I really like it under this window, especially with the blinds open and you can see out to the patio. I really like the look of that. I should be hanging my curtains back up. I'm gonna actually move these up a little closer to the ceiling. And these tie back thingies, I'm gonna take those off because I won't be tying my curtains back ever again. As a matter of fact, I don't know if I ever tied them back. I'm gonna be removing those tie back thingies. I also have them on the, I also have the tie back thingies on this wall over here because the way I had the sheer curtain styled on this window before, they weren't really tied back. They were just kind of tied around. If I have a clip of it, I'll put it in here so you can see what I'm talking about. But either way, I'm gonna take these down because I won't be using them anymore. And I think I remember somebody asking me about the decor that I have right in the entrance of our master bedroom. So pretty much everything you see here came from Target. The round mirror came from Target. I think the brand is Project 62. The faux fiddle tree came from Target. I think it was like a Threshold brand. I think it might have been $30. And the bench came from Target, but I got it online. I didn't get it in store. And the pillow came from, let me fix this, y'all. There we go. Wait. The pillow came from Home Goods. Sorry, y'all, I had to fix that. The pillow came from Home Goods. I bought it for Christmas last year because of the print that it has on it, and I ended up not liking it. So now I just use it as everyday decor. But yeah, for the person that asked me about this, I don't remember if they asked me on Instagram or on here. I don't know. But yeah, that's what it is. Everything over here came from Target except the pillow. And I will try to link all of these things down below just in case you're interested.
Good morning, y'all. Happy Sunday, y'all. Sorry, I'm having my coffee. It's like 8 in the morning and I want to get this video finished so that I can upload it for y'all today. Now that I've showed you guys all of the pieces in the living room that I've bought so far, in the next video, we're going to start styling and decorating them because I'm kind of tired of staring at them, having nothing on them like that. Console back there, it's been sitting like that since I bought it. I filled it with stuff, so the storage is great in it, but I still haven't put any decorations on it. So in the next video, we're gonna start doing that. And also this sofa table that's behind me that I got from Target. I was gonna do a little bit of shopping yesterday, but my husband told me that it was tax-free weekend and it was gonna be a lot of people out on the loop in the shopping area. And when I got out there, it was jam-packed, so it was a no for me. So I just went to Home Goods because I know no one was gonna be shopping in there for school supplies and school clothes. And while I was in there, I bought this really huge planner that I've been wanting for a long time. As a matter of fact, you can kind of see it right there. I put it right there because I'm gonna put that tree in it. This is the tree that I did the faux plant hack on a couple of videos back. Well, I decided that I really don't like the way it looks anymore, so I'm gonna put it in that pot right there, and I'll show you what that looks like in the next video. I'm also gonna rehang my curtains on those windows back there and these right in front of me. Yesterday, I spent a lot of time touching up paint and retouching this wall right here. So in a few days, it'll be completely dry and I'll hang my new curtain rod. I bought a brand new bay window curtain rod to put up here. I got it from Lowe's. You'll see it in the next video, but I thought it would look really good hanging here with all of the shears on it. And both windows have these tie back things on them that kind of match the curtain rods. I'm going to unscrew those and kind of spackle the holes and repaint over those because I don't need them anymore. I'm actually going to let all of the curtains just hang straight, and I'm going to hang them a lot closer to the ceiling because that'll give the illusion that the room is a lot bigger than it is. Even though I feel like we already have a nice size living space back there, I'm still going to hang the curtains a lot higher than they were before. Sorry, y'all, this coffee is so good. As far as my bar cart, please comment below and let me know what you think of it. Did I put too much on it? Do I need to add something else to it, take something away? Like I told y'all, I knew I could overstuff it with decor. Sometimes when you're on the outside looking in, when you're seeing it on this video, you may see something that I don't see. Yeah, you guys just let me know if I overdid it or it looks perfect the way it is. Just let me know what you think. Also, in the next video, I have a couple of DIY projects that I want to share with y'all. And we also have a couple of new things that we have going on in the guest bathroom, so I want to be able to show you those things as well. So yeah, if you want to see how I decorate all of the new pieces that I've gotten, stay tuned for the next video. I got to get them decorated, y'all, because I don't want fall to sneak up on me and I don't have time to finish enjoying my summer decor. And most of you probably feel the same way I do. You're ready for fall, but you want to get done with summer first. These 105 degree days are horrible, but I don't want to rush it along, you know what I mean? Time moves too fast already. And I won't be putting out any of my fall decor until like the last week of September, 1st of October, somewhere in there. So I still have plenty of time to enjoy my summer stuff. I just need to get it put out. It's all in the guest room sitting in a corner anyway. It's just waiting on me. And I feel good with the pieces that I have. I finally went through all my decor. I gave my mom a lot. I donated a lot. So I'm happy with the things that I kept. So now I just need to start using them again so I can see how they look in the new space. Because the thing about it, y'all, it's August now. And we had these floors done at the very end of May. And we got the new furniture the first week of June. And I've been buying pieces here and there ever since. And everything is still sitting blank and empty. So it's time to decorate. But yeah, I'm gonna do my best to get this video uploaded today because I also need to wash my hair. I actually need to dye my hair because around the roots are starting to get gray again. And I hate that it's my roots that get gray around the edges, around my hairline. If it got gray up here in the middle or in the back, I wouldn't even care. But it's right around my hairline. Normally when I re-dye my hair red, I just have it in two braids. Normally when I re-dye my hair red, I try to take it all the way to the roots so that I can get that gray. Some of them actually dye red and some of them actually turn like pinkish or rose gold or something like that. But so yeah, I need to re-dye my hair and get it washed. I need to do my laundry for the work week. I need to change the sheets on the bed. Sundays for me are like a reset day, y'all. I do all of the things for the entire upcoming work week on Sunday. I sit down at my desk and I plan out my week. I change my nail polish, whatever the things I need to do to get me ready for the week, mentally, physically, all the things, I do them on Sunday. And speaking of nail polish, this polish is, what is this I'm wearing? Hold please. Okay, I said I was gonna show y'all every time I wear a polish in a video, I was gonna tell you what it was. In this video, it spanned a couple of days, so there was different polish a lot, and I don't even remember on some of the days what I had on. One day I had on Big Apple Red. Another day I had on Rainbow Nails, because my niece and I, we do a dare every day, and my dare one day was to wear rainbow nails. So I wore a different color on every nail. You probably saw that in one of the clips. But today I'm actually wearing Roam With Me by Orly. That's the new color that I have on. And then over the top of that, I'm wearing this new polish that I just got from Polish Pickup, the July Rewind. And it's from Nailed It, and it's called There's a Nap for That. It probably would have looked good on its own, but I thought it was gonna look a little bit sheer, so I just put these two together. So that's what I'm wearing. I'm actually gonna change it today because, like I said, Sunday reset. I just have no idea what I'm gonna use when I get in there. Sometimes I share my polish of the day on Instagram stories, so if you follow me on Instagram, you may catch it on my stories over there. So anyway, I'm gonna do my best to remember to do this in every video, but that's the polish that I'm wearing today, y'all. I've actually had it on for 2.5 days now. But anyway, y'all, I could ramble on and on about these things for the rest of the day. So I'm gonna go get my laptop and maybe sit out on the patio so I can edit this video, enjoy the rest of this coffee so you guys can enjoy this video this evening. So if you have any questions about anything, leave them down in the comments. I'm gonna link as many things as I can. I try to link things, but sometimes things aren't linkable, so I just have to list them instead of linking them. But either way, I'll list or link as many things as I can down in the description box below. And I never say this anymore because I feel like at this point it's kind of cheesy, but if you like the content that I'm giving, subscribe to the channel. Make sure you hit that little notification bell so you won't miss any of my future uploads. Leave a comment, share the video with a friend, you know, all the YouTube stuff. But I really do appreciate all of y'all that come back each time and watch my videos. And with saying that, I thank you for watching this one, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.